Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Pierre. So I've got some pretty big news today. I'm sure a lot of people have heard recently that squash didn't get into the Paris Olympics in 2024. So I thought it was probably time for me to realize that like this whole squash equipment thing just it doesn't really have a future. And so I'm gonna probably need to switch things up here on Squash Source. And I thought, you know, probably I'm still working out like my new direction to go with the whole channel and blog and stuff. I was thinking about maybe starting to review, you know, different like breakdancing equipment, like maybe trying on like different hats. This is the only real hat I have. Thanks, Squash Unlimited. I was thinking about maybe, you know, trying different stuff and like maybe reviewing different types of cardboard for my breakdancing setup. Like if you want to go out, you know, do it like old school in the streets. So let's take a look at some breakdancing videos so that we can just see what it's all about. I kind of assume that the real reason that the Olympics wants breakdancing is because they have totally different experience online when you're watching the video. So let's find out. Here we've got the Battle of the Year 2018. That sounds pretty good. Jinjo Crew. KR versus Foundation JP. Oh, Korea versus Japan. Okay. It's global. They got that going for them. Let's see. They got hashtags. BOTY. That stands for Battle of the Year. All right, let's see what it's like on here.
Money. We are back.
Money. Here we go. Looks like they don't use cardboard anymore. At least not for this.
If I was to say cool it now, who would you say? Cool it right now.
First guy says, if I was to say call it right now, he's talking to the other guy, what would you say? And the other guy says,
well, why you gotta put me on blast?
Because that's the game we play, right?
Why you gotta put me on blast? And because that's the game we play. They're just like us. I want to see the next time on Squash TV when Joey turns to PJ and says, hey PJ, I want your prediction for this match. I want PJ to turn to Joey and say, why you gotta put me on blast? You see, they're just like us. They're having fun. They're enjoying their favorite activity. And they're just having a good time. I don't understand. It's almost like, well, let's see what happens. Here we go. Getting ready, getting geared up.
I'm
not sure which team that is.
But I'm sure Foundation's going to win as well.
Yeah, of course.
Give it up to the Red Bull BC One All-Stars. We have Issei, Hansen, and Wynn representing.
Should be able to tell the difference between the Korean team and the Japanese team. Sorry. They're not like wearing any, they got Red Bull on, just like short baggy. Wait a second, they're just like us. He's got a Jordan sweater, that's different. There's the cat. I'm ready. I gotta work on that move.
Obligatory head spins.
See, we don't have obligatory moves in squash. We're more creative. We can do whatever we want. Okay. Ooh, the hat goes flying off. All right. Well, you see, I feel like they're just doing their own thing, and it's almost like maybe we should just do our own thing and not worry about the freaking Olympics so much. This is pretty awesome. I don't have anything against breakdancing, which you may have heard has been selected as one of the 2024 sports for the Olympics. And I don't know, the Olympics, they got their own stuff going on. They're trying to figure out how to like not lose their billion-dollar TV contract because everyone's like cutting the cord and watching stuff on YouTube just like this. And maybe they're worried. Maybe we squash players need to be putting out clips of our amazing Knicks, of which I have many clips of those, of my Knicks off the serve return. So many. I'm going to be putting them up right now. At least I have that one. That was like the only point I won that game, because I couldn't figure out any other way to win a point against that guy, which was a problem. Anyway, let's move on. Let's just move on. Not just from this part of the fake section of this April 1st video, but from the whole Olympics thing. Like, let's just play squash. Let's just do the thing we love to do. Let's go for it. All right. So we are going to give a couple of equipment updates and a couple of news updates. First of all, I've been just starting to test out this Oliver Apex 550. I hit with this yesterday for the first time. I'm gonna do a separate video with the weights and a little bit more in depth. This is a very kind of whippy racket. Feels, I like, usually, you know, if you've been watching a lot of squash sort videos, you know I like a nice solid kind of thudding almost racket. And this one feels like when you hit the ball, you can actually feel it bend a little bit. It's not my normal kind of racket. But it is a beauty, I have to say. The this red and black and silver look. And of course, just got used to it when I was playing with it and was working out just fine. Thanks, Peter from Oliver, for sending me that one. And thanks to Stefan from Racket Guys for these Yonex shoes. So these are called Yonex Power Cushion Comfort Tour. And I have just played with them one time. They were comfortable right away. A couple things I noticed about them, aside from the fact that they go really well with this Oliver racket, and I felt good out there. I wish I had a video of my look that day. So they have an interesting lacing pattern here, and it's kind of curved along the line of your foot, which I've never tried a shoe that way before. And actually, instead of the usual tongue situation like these Harrow Typhoons, which have the normal tongue that can go either way in a straight up and down lacing pattern, these have a kind of two-piece design. The tongue continues on from here and in one motion goes all the way over, and then the other side comes up and laces you together. So it's, the tongue is kind of attached to the one side, and that makes for a really secure hold. Actually, it was felt really nice. I actually noticed, by the way, these Harrows that I was using and the Yonex are very similar. I think they must be, you know, these must be made by a sort of similar manufacturer. The lacing system is completely different, and there's a few other differences in the cosmetics and sort of the outward sign of things, but they did feel similar in terms of the grip, and it feels similar in terms of weight as well. Another thing that made me realize the similarity to the Harrow one was the insole. Here's the Harrow insole, and it had those ridges that have been worn down a little bit since I played in those a lot, and the Yonex has the same kind. Same kind of ridges, so similar insole, nice and padded and removable for getting rid of your shoe odor, which I know you want to do. Anyhow, on to the Power Cushion Comfort Tour. This is how much does this cost? So actually, you say on the side Comfort Z. Stefan said Comfort Tour, but here on the shoe it says Comfort Z and or Z. Since I found out recently, looking at my stats, that more people from the UK watch my show than people from the US watch my YouTube videos, that is. So I've got to make sure that I go for the English pronunciation. This is the Power Cushion Comfort Z, and these in the US are $140, so on the pricier side. All right, thanks for tuning in to this Squash Source update. I'll be back soon with another one. I'm enjoying these, and hopefully you are too. Thanks for all the comments you left the last few videos. All right, see ya.